Hello and welcome to episode 22 of Unpacking Articles. The article we're going to unpack today is called Vocabulary Acquisition in a Second Language. Do learners really acquire most vocabulary by reading? Some empirical evidence. And as the title implies, the author is tackling this frequently cited benefit of reading, learning words. Is it really true that reading is the best way to learn new words, or is it something that we have all come to accept without questioning? The author is not talking about the value of reading in general. She is specifically talking about whether reading is the most effective way of learning new words. Do we pick up new words from reading? The reason why we have all heard that reading is the best way to learn vocab is because this is true when it comes to your first language. The bulk of L1 lexicon, the words you know in your first language, is indeed acquired incidentally. And reading is indeed very good for first language development. But the author points out that we cannot just conclude that whatever is true for the L1 context also applies to second language learners in a classroom. In the first part of the article, the author dissects the assumptions that we need to make if we're going to claim that reading is indeed the best way to learn new words in a classroom. First, the learner needs to notice the word. Then the learner needs to be able to guess the meaning of the word they just noticed. And then we need to assume that they will retain the meaning they just guessed from the word they just noticed. And if they don't remember after just one encounter, which I guess we could say, yes, that's true, after one encounter, how likely is that? Then we need to assume the students will have multiple chances to re-encounter those words so they can acquire them. All of these assumptions would need to be met to acquire a new word from reading. All of these for a new word. And so the author says that for that to happen, we are going up against tough odds. And all of these assumptions have their issues. First, learners might not really notice new words. We would love to think that they do, but oftentimes if they can understand the overall message of the text, then they don't even notice that there was a new word in a sentence, or they might think they understood what that word was when in reality they didn't. Furthermore, some words look similar, and so the students might think that's not a new word. They don't notice it as a new word. For example, adopt and adapt. Let's say they know the word adopt. So when they see the word adapt in a text, they don't notice, they don't recognize it as a new word. And this quote explains why this is a challenge, particularly in instructed L2 learning. It says, because of the relative paucity of input, words are encountered less frequently than in the natural language learning context. Consequently, many words are somewhat familiar but not yet firmly established in the mental lexicon and prone to confusion with similar looking or sounding words. Okay, issue number two. Correctly guessing from context is very hard. We tend to tell students, well, try to guess from context. That's a lot easier said than done. And it's a lot easier in our first language than in a second or additional language. Another issue that arises is that even if we accept that new words are noticed and guessed correctly, that's a big if, will they be retained? Well, it depends. One factor the author talks about is processing effort. Essentially, if it's easy for you to figure out what the word means, then it's less likely that you'll retain it, that you'll remember what it is. The more effort we have to put to figure out the meaning of a word, the more likely it is that we will remember what it means. And why is that relevant? Because if we're claiming that reading is the best way to learn new vocab, then how realistic is it to expect students to put a lot of effort trying to figure out the meaning of new words so that they remember them? And this quote sums it up very nicely. It says, when the learners are expected to read large quantities of text on their own and in a limited period of time, it is doubtful whether they will interrupt the flow of reading and invest time in guessing with difficulty. Words which can be guessed with ease without interfering with reading will indeed be guessed. The problem is that most of them will not be retained. And the fourth issue, which is related to the fourth assumption we mentioned earlier, also has to do with unrealistic expectations. We know from research that a word needs to be encountered multiple times, and some suggest at least 10 encounters, and not just 10 plus encounters, but in close proximity, before it is forgotten, says the author. How realistic is it to encounter the same word 10 plus times in a text? Even if we found a text that is perfect, where a new word appears 10 times, then are students just learning one new word? You can see why the author wonders if it is the most efficient and effective way of learning new words. In the second part of the article, the author talks about the empirical evidence she alluded to in the title. What research seems to tell us is that students remember the meaning of more words if they do something in addition to reading. That's what she calls reading plus, as opposed to reading only. A lot of the studies are actually comparing dictionary use versus simply glossing. In other words, having the students look up the words versus we provide the translations in the margin or in parentheses as they read. And then the author presents data from three experiments. In experiment 1 and 2, reading with glosses was compared to sentence writing. And the results showed that when students were asked to write a sentence using the words provided in a word bank, the students remembered those words better than the group that only read a text with glosses. And in the second experiment, it was compared to composition writing, so writing not just a sentence, but using a word bank in a composition, in a paragraph. And once again, the active group, if you will, did better in remembering those words than just reading with glosses. Now, the fine print that is worth pointing out to me is that the retention rates decreased significantly 2 weeks later, so in the delayed post-test. For both conditions, students tended to forget what the target words meant after 2 weeks. So can we really say that anybody really learned the words? Okay, but now let's look at experiment 3, because in experiment 3, there was one group that retained the words for 2 weeks. And in experiment 3, they compared three conditions: reading with a dictionary, so the students had to look up the words, the targeted words; writing sentences, the words were provided with the translation, the students were asked to create sentences using those words; and sentence completion with dictionary, so the students were asked to fill in the blanks using certain words, but they were asked to look up those words in the dictionary first to figure out where they would go, in which sentence. So in the immediate post-test, the writing and fill in the blanks group did better than the reading group. And in the delayed post-test, 2 weeks later, the only group that retained the words, the other ones really, they forgot the words, but the only one that came out on top is the fill in the blanks group. Why is that? My explanation, the only thing that I can think of, is that the fill in the blanks group was the most word focused of all the groups. The group that was just reading, even though they had to look things up in a dictionary, they still had to worry about everything else that was happening in the text, and then they had some comprehension questions. So their attention was spread thin, so to speak. They were not focusing solely on those words. Even the writing sentences group, they were provided with the translation, so you could say they didn't have to put a whole lot of effort figuring out what the word meant. And second, their attention went somewhere else to figure out what I need for the rest of the sentence. But the sentence completion with dictionary, the students had to figure out what the words meant, so they engaged with the dictionary. And then on top of that, they were really focused on just that word, writing that word in a sentence. So there might be something there that we need to consider, especially for future research and also for our own activities in our classroom. And you might think, but of course, students are more likely to remember when they're actively involved. Maybe that's not a very surprising finding. And you might also be thinking, but of course, one encounter is not enough. Did we really expect the reading-only group to remember 10 new words they encounter just once in a reading? So the bottom line is, reading is good, but Is it good for learning new words? According to this author, too many conditions would need to be met. And so, going back to the question in the title of the article, do learners really acquire most vocabulary by reading? The answer is, don't count on it. But the real question to me is that why we read? Perhaps I'm wrong, but I don't think teachers ask learners to read something just to learn new words. There's much more to reading than learning words or learning new words. In addition to the many general benefits of reading for language development, there are many vocab-specific benefits to reading that don't involve new words. And I love this quote from a different article, but it's so good that I have to include it here. It says, reading can enrich their knowledge of the words they already know, increase lexical access speeds, build network linkages between words, and a few words will be acquired. The reason why I love that quote is because of that last part, like, oh, by the way, maybe you learn a few words. And that takes me to the takeaway. Acquiring new words from reading might be more like dessert, not the main course. But even if there's no dessert, you can still enjoy the main course. That's just my take on it. As usual, I encourage you to read the original and draw your own conclusions. Thank you for tuning in, and until next time.